Good Saturday morning to you folks. Hopefully things are going well with you and you are well rested, ready to face the day. I'm going to read to you just a piece of scripture, and we know this, probably know it by heart, but a piece of scripture here found in the book of John in chapter 3. There was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. The same came to Jesus by night and said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher come from God, for no man can do these miracles that thou doest, except God be with him. Jesus answered and said unto him, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. This isn't a conversation between someone who knows absolutely nothing about God and the Son of God. This is a conversation between the Son of God and somebody who teaches about God, who talks about God, whose livelihood, whose duty, whose call was to be not only a ruler of the Jews, a man of the Pharisees, but a teacher of those. And Jesus says to him, you must be born again. Nicodemus said unto him, how can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born? So that tells you right there that he was thinking with a carnal mind. He was not thinking any spiritual nature at all. Jesus answered, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. That which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I said unto thee, ye must be born again. So Nicodemus then wants to know, how can these things be? And Jesus goes on with that conversation. I find that there are a lot of folks who have a lot of questions. I did. Anybody that's a Christian today probably did. And I don't understand everything about being saved. All I know is I was lost and now I'm found. It's like the blind man that Jesus healed. They ask and ask and ask, trying to bring an accusation against Jesus. They ask this blind man, who did this? How did he do this? How did this happen? Finally, he got so frustrated, he said, I've already told you. Will you hear it again? Will you be his disciple or his follower as well? He said, all I know is I was blind and now I see. I don't have to know how it all took place. All I need to know is I needed a savior. And it's a good thing that he came passing by my way. I'm going to try this song. Never tried it. I've had this in my songbook for probably 25 years. It's usually a three or four parts song when I was doing bluegrass gospel. We never did work it up, I guess. I really need a bass singer and different people, but we'll give it a shot today anyhow. Wake up, old sinner, you're facing the darkness of day. Each moment might be the moment you take your last breath. And the weight of your fears are the shackles that keep you enslaved. But the blood of the Lamb is the one way to bypass the grave. The first step to heaven is knowing you're lost. The highway to glory is the way of the cross. You can hand him your burdens the moment you see. The first step to heaven is down on your knees. To all you believers who have answered the Good Shepherd's call, flood the chasm of darkness with the light that can save one and all. Not a soul crosses Jordan on the strength of their money or deeds. That mansion up yonder is reserved for those who believe. The first step to heaven is knowing your laws. The highway to glory is the way of the cross. You can hand him your burden the moment you see. The first step to heaven is down on your knees. You can hand him your burden the moment you see. The first step to heaven is down on your knees. Lord, we're thankful that not only must we be born again, but we're thankful that we have a Savior who has redeemed us, who gave his life for all believers and for all those who do not yet believe. And God, the opportunity lays before them. It is our duty, our obligation to tell others about the Lord. And upon the dealing and drawing power of the Holy Spirit is their duty and obligation to answer. We must be born again. Not everybody chooses that. I'm glad that you chose me, and I'm glad that I accepted. I love you. I thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. Folks, if you watched this tomorrow, if you look for it, of course, you know this is 611 of these things so far, and never been one on a Sunday. We're in church on Sunday. Tomorrow morning, the Carter sisters and Neil will be back from a hiatus. Vail had throat surgery, and she is back and ready to go for their service of the Lord, and they start back. We're starting back in March. Beginning of March, I tried to get them to come the end of February, the last Sunday, and was successful, so I'm glad. So watch that tomorrow. You'll see them. Better yet, 7432 North State Route 139, Lucasville. Come and be with us if you're close enough. Anywhere's close enough, as long as you got a car, right? Or an airplane. But come and be with us. We'd love to have you. God bless. See you, if not tomorrow, see you on Monday.